Well, this is morning of day four. It's about 6 o'clock in the morning. There she hangs. Now, I don't have a food bag, so I took my backpack cover, threw everything in it. And I have my rope, threw it over that branch, tied it to this tree. Back on the trail, got about 0.3 of a mile to go to get to Forest Service Road 560. From there, I hope to hitchhike it all the way into Bailey for my first resupply. Beautiful morning, sun's just peeking out, so it's exactly 7 o'clock right now. I'm glad to be back on the trail. Well, right now we're about 8,150 feet elevation. And yeah, in 0.3, it'll be 0.3 of a mile. It'll also be segment number four. And at the end of segment four, it's over 10,000 feet elevation already. So, see how I feel. Forest Service Road 560, Colorado Trail. I'm all done segment three. It finished it when I got onto this road. I want to say that segment three was pretty much all just in the woods, like the whole way. There was no vast distances, views, or anything like that. Just in the woods. It was nice. But can't wait to see them huge mountains and vast distances. And all that beautiful stuff. Alright, well, everything worked out really well. I got picked up by a search and rescue lady. Really nice lady. She's been living in Colorado her life. And yeah, and then got all the way into Bailey. Got these Bailey Country Store only opened at 8:30. And then there's Cutthroat Cafe right beside it, where I had punched out some money and had a really good breakfast. I had bacon, eggs, toast, two cups of coffee. That was a really good place to eat. I would definitely recommend having breakfast there. And Bailey Country Store right beside it. The fella inside, his name is Jim. Really helpful guy. I had my resupply box sent there. He had it there waiting for me. And everything just worked out better than I could have honestly hoped for. So then I went over to the post office across the street and shipped some stuff back, some food that I didn't eat, some camera gear, my two Nalgene bottles. I replaced them with some skinny 1 liter tall bottles of water. A lot less weight. And then I bought a mug from the Bailey Country Store there. Sent that back with the box of stuff that I don't need anymore in the post office as a souvenir for myself. Yeah, everything just worked out absolutely wonderful. Lady in the post office was really helpful as well. And now I'm heading back to the trail. It's about 8 miles back, but I hope to get a ride again. On my way into Bailey, I probably walked about 3/4 of a mile. And that's when the lady from the search and rescue picked me up and brought me all the way to the country store. So that was really nice of her. And yeah, hopefully I have some good luck with hitchhiking a ride back into or onto the Colorado Trail. Beautiful sunny day. It's a beautiful Saturday morning. It's about 10 o'clock right now. I got on this road off the Colorado Trail today about 7 in the morning. And it's about 10 o'clock right now. And hope to be back on the trail in just a little while. Make some decent miles in on segment number 4. Woo! Yeah, everything's worked out really well. In Littleton, here in Bailey, the trail's been wonderful, the weather's been wonderful. My body feels good. My pack feels wonderful. I'm glad I sent that stuff home. There's a little over 5 pounds with the cup that I bought that I'm shipping back home to my mom. And I couldn't ask for a better trip so far. I really couldn't. It's been wonderful. Hope it keeps up. And the search and rescue lady said that a week before I showed up, they had every single day pretty much a torrential downpour, and now the weather is supposed to get a lot better too. So she said I just missed all the rain, so that was really good to hear as well. Everyone's so nice, such great hospitality, and yeah, just a great experience so far. Next resupply is in 5 days in Breckenridge, and hopefully it keeps up. I got about 60 miles to go to Breckenridge, and hopefully I can do it in about 4 days. Get a little bit of ahead of schedule would be nice, but so far I'm doing pretty good. Well, I probably walked about 1/4 of a mile out of Bailey, and this lovely lady picked me up, brought me all the way to Miller Gulch, the turn off to the left, Miller Gulch trailhead. So she dropped me off, and now I just got a little ways to go to Lost Creek Wilderness Trailhead. Be nice if I got another hitchhike or another ride up to there. sure I will. There's a lot of nice people. A lot of nice people out here. Traffic's pretty high. Here we are at the Lost Creek Wilderness Trailhead. Colorado Trail just comes down that hill there, winding. Went resupplied in Bailey, came back. Here I am, continuing on the Colorado Trail. Start of segment 4, and at the end of segment 4, it's about 10,100 feet elevation or something like that, maybe a little more. I'm forgetting exactly what the guidebook said. And it's about 16 miles, a little over 16 miles this segment, segment number 4. Alright. Alright, there's another little trailhead that you run into. Just a little bit off of Highway 560. And then you hang a right. The other one is a different trail. What is the other one? Rolling Creek Trail. If you go that way, right in through those trees. And this way continues on the Colorado Trail. Just after this little campground's parking spot or whatever. And it's kind of this rocky path right here. It's pretty much all that segment 4 has been so far. Well, hopefully there's some awesome views in this segment. Really wouldn't mind seeing some really nice wide areas. Oh, just up and up and up. All right. Well, there are some clouds brewing, but they seem to be nice and white and fluffy. Hopefully they're not. Hopefully they're not gonna all of a sudden go any darker and start raining. I have been lucky with weather, but it is Colorado. After all, there's these bugs. Type of flies, they're just all around. Especially when you start sweating, smell a little stinky. Yeah, there are like 2 or 3 of them around you all the time. And when they do land, they bite pretty good. They don't leave a mark or an itch or nothing. As soon as they're gone, it's just a bite. But my goodness, is it ever irritating. They're not horse flies either. I've seen a couple of them, but these are not them. These are almost worse, believe it or not. Segment 4, mile 1.9. We are entering the Lost Creek Wilderness at 9,000 feet elevation. Permit required. Stop here. Lost Creek Wilderness, Colorado, Rolling Creek Trailhead. Alright, well, it's sprinkling again. I've been hearing thunder for a while. That's pretty much the same as yesterday. Just a slight drizzle, but enough to get you wet. Still walking through this pretty dense pine forest. Big wide trail, but yeah, hopefully it stops raining soon. Creek Trail, just down that way. Colorado Trail keeps climbing up this way. Really loving this segment 4 already. This beautiful path, beautiful trees. Hopefully the sky clears up. Raining today, a little bit wet here. Pretty nice though. A little bit of hop, skip, jump on these rocks. Pretty nice. Just down like a 1,000 calories. Hell yeah. Feeling I'm gonna be tired after this one. All this rocky land makes it a little bit slower as well. Twist your ankle or anything.
I can't believe it's an old logging road. Had to be one hell of a vehicle to go up and down here. Then yeah, with logs, oh my goodness. That was a rocky, rocky area. Oh, we got another 600 feet. To climb, so you get off this old logging road onto the trail.
All right, well, now that we're off the logging road into the woods, still climbing. Trail ain't nowhere near as wide as the logging road, obviously, but it's fairly well laid out. Shit, I think my pack might be close to 56 pounds, probably. Right now, even after shipping that stuff home, but it's not too bad though. Legs are feeling good. Body feels good. Mentally, I'm still definitely in the game. That's for sure. I'm loving it out here. This climb is pretty exhausting, but hey, that's what I signed up for. Breathing a little heavy. I think we're probably at 10,000 feet already. Again, the highest I've ever been. Ooh. Oh boy. The top of this climb will be around 10,400 feet. Yeah. Still a bit cloudy, but I think that's almost a good thing. This would be really, really hard if it was sunny out and really muggy. Wow, that would be tough. Sun is shining, but it's raining a little bit. Well, the trail's still going up. Higher and higher. Yeah, I must say, had I not done all those years of roofing, carrying up 80 to 100 pounds worth of shingles up a 1-2-3 story building and doing that pretty much all day, shingling and getting bundles, bringing bundles up the ladder and then bringing them all the way to the top of the roof yet. I think that toughened up my legs and my feet like crazy, even though I haven't done it in a while. I think that helps me out a lot. And I must say, 12 hours of roofing, you can get more tired than 12 hours of hiking, even if it's like this pretty much. And a 60-70 pound pack. I mean, some days when I came home from roofing, oh my goodness, it was just shower and hit the sack. Hardly even eat a damn thing because he's so tired.
Should be rejoining that old logging road very soon. Yeah, I think my knees, they don't like downhill. Uphill, it's not bad. They were strong and not bad at all. But I think downhill is a lot worse for my knees. A little bit easier. You don't have to be climbing and shit, but on your knees, it's just a little bit harder. Well, since we got back on this logging road, it's actually been really nice hiking back to a nice flat trail, not so rocky. And it's all pretty much downhill. Well, has been for a little while since you get back onto the old logging road. All right, well, here we are. We are exiting the Lost Creek Wilderness. I think this is the meadow that we're going to be going down into and following for a while.
All right, into the meadow we go. We had 6 miles in this meadow, and the data book says that's surprisingly straight, 6 miles. I'll be the judge of that, I guess. But what a beautiful area. I just ran into 2 girls from Denver, and they were really intrigued with doing the Colorado Trail as well, and they're out here just to see how they would like maybe 3-4 days of it. They had never gone out and hiked and camped before, so it was a new experience for them as well. And said if they really liked it, they'd maybe do the CT in the future, which I definitely recommend, because it's sweet! Unbelievably beautiful out here. There's some clouds in the sky, but it's just beautiful.
just as you get into the meadow, if you do need water, there's a nice little river or stream right here. I guess it's more like a river. So if you need water, there it is. It's just a little ways once you get into this meadow. Okay. You can get into the Lost Creek Wilderness here too. Some car campers and stuff. I think this is where those two girls must have parked to get out onto the trail. Colorado Trail just continues left over there. Comes from over there and just keeps going up that way. What a nice river here though. And we keep going. 6 miles in this beautiful meadow. It's gonna be nice. There's a fellow over there too doing the CT. Today's the first day, it's the fourth day, but it's the first day that I haven't put second skin on my feet or duct tape or anything. And they're feeling really good. With all the uphill and downhill I did there, and now through this meadow already, yeah, feeling really good. No hot spots, no blisters. Well, there's no sign here, but I take it this is the Brookside Trail that meets up in the middle here with CT. Oh boy, there's some dark clouds coming up above me. I think I got another 4 miles or so to get out of here, out of this meadow. I really hope it doesn't start raining on me. This is the water source that I just got my water from.
eating some trail mix. I'm gonna have a late supper. Still got a little ways to go. It was raining there again for a little bit. It's still sprinkling a little. You can see a bunch of frogs jumping. These little water pools. Oh, what a beautiful afternoon. This is by far my favorite section that I've hiked in yet. I like Waterton Canyon. The ram and the mule deer and all the high rocky walls on the sides. That was really nice. And then the burn area was really beautiful. But this, oh my goodness, with the clouds and sun going down. It's just really, really nice. We're still heading out the meadow. It's been a long trip, seems like. I also was a bit slow. I photographed this area, the entire meadow pretty much, a lot. Took a little bit of my time. Here we are at the end of day 4. I'm not quite out of the meadow yet, but I seen a couple of guys down there getting water. I think the rest of the group that he was part of the group that I seen yesterday across the little stream where I was camping, a group of 6 or 7. I did talk to them yesterday. Yeah, 2 of them are from Canada, Vancouver. I don't remember their names now, but either way. I don't know, and there's a campsite just a little bit ahead. I'm not sure how much room this campsite has, so figured I would just make myself a little spot here so that I wouldn't have to come back or something like that and then find a spot. As you can see, it's not 100% level, but where my bed's gonna be, it actually is pretty level. I worked the land there a little bit. And it's pretty darn soft with all these pine needles. So, got a great view of the meadow. Sun is going down. I'm gonna set up a time lapse. Watch the sun go all the way down. I'm gonna make some food and relax. Been another 14 mile day plus a
resupply in Bailey, so pretty happy with my accomplishment today. What I all achieved. Oh, I still love it. Every minute of it. I wouldn't rather be anywhere else than right here, right now. Sleeping my good old tent out in the woods on the Colorado Trail. Another hamburger helper. Had one in this resupply that I picked up this morning. It was so good last time. Simmer. Some olive oil in there for some extra calories.